So where is the energy stored? In the previous example, we had three charges, two plus and one minus. And we want to know, well, is the energy stored in the charges, somehow in the space between? And the answer is that the energy is stored in something called the electric field. Now, the concept of a field is a strange one, so don't worry if this isn't intuitive at first. We actually could have talked about this concept of a field when we talked about gravity. So for example, if you look at the Earth, we can draw these imaginary arrows pointed towards the center of the Earth. And these arrows somehow indicate what will happen if I put a mass near them. So if I put a mass near this arrow, well, it will feel force in the direction that the arrow is pointing. These arrows are somehow representing the gravitational field. The electric field is very similar. In the same way that gravity is caused by mass, electric fields are created by charges. And just as gravitational fields are felt by mass, electric fields are felt by charges. So both created and felt by objects with charge. Interesting. Now, how are we going to measure the electric field? Well, it must have some strength associated with it. The way we measure that strength is by putting a small test particle of charge, let's say plus Q, somewhere. And if there's an electric field, this object will feel a force. Electric fields cause forces. And of course, if this charge were bigger, the force would be bigger. But it seems like there's something more fundamental going on than the force on this particular charge. So actually, what we want to do is define the electric field in the following way. As being equal to the force, but we divide by whatever the charge of the particle we're putting in is. So if we found that there was some force in this direction, that means there must have also been an electric field in this direction at this point. So as a quick example of how to use this equation, E equals F over Q, let's say we take our plus 1 Coulomb charge, set it down somewhere, and note that it feels a force to the right of 4 newtons. Well, the electric field is just force over charge, 4 over 1, and both of those numbers are positive. So in this case, the E field, electric field, would be 4 newtons per coulomb. And maybe I'd want to say something like to the right, because electric field is a vector, has both a size and a direction. Now, what if I gave you a different problem? Let's say I have a negative charge that, when placed in a certain electric field, feels a force of 10 newtons to the right. Can you fill this out for me? Can you tell me what the strength of the electric field is? And that strength should be a positive number. And can you tell me whether it's an electric field to the right or to the left?